with 6 meter Russian telescope in the optical with high time resolution. The observation was done in February this year. This instrument, Mania, the time resolution, this is such an instrument which allows to get high time resolution light curves and polarization in ideal with 100 nanosecond resolution. But it depends on the brightness of the object. But that's all. I skip this PP dot diagram, but yeah, only mention that we have another jubilee that millisecond pulsar have been detected, has been discovered 35 years ago. It was a puzzle why they rotate so rapidly, and recycling mechanism has been immediately proposed by two groups, by Alpar et al. And two Indian scientists. And it was not clear is it right or not, while most millisecond pulsars are in binary system. This was a supporting fact. Then it was strongly supported by discovery of coherent millisecond pulsations for this source in X-rays. And I would like to say that compact rotation millisecond pulsars in binaries show two distinct classes, black widows and so-called red bugs, in which system, as has been clear from the previous thought, the non-degenerate companion or white dwarfs, so they are heated from the side of the neutron stars. The prototype of the name red bug is a spider, Australian spider. That's picture just demonstrating how the hit the face of the companion. And the final point in establishing low mass X-ray binary rotation pulsars connection was provided by three recently discovered red bugs. Two of them has been mentioned, and there is another one at probably two candidates. So only 20 years we confirmed that scenario to the end. So these are three pulsars, they come from, they transform online, practically, from low mass X-ray binary state to. But most interesting that PSR J1023 shows back, returned back to the low mass X-ray binary 4 years ago. This demonstrates that transition itself is a complicated process, challenging additional studies. This was the motivation. So the back, right, there is intra-binary shock. Anybody knows it. Demonstrates in the some story about this pulsar. This is a cartoon of the structure of the object during the rotation pulsar state. that there is intrabinary shock, and X-rays likely come from this shock and modulated with the binary period. I actually show the achievements of a group from Amsterdam, which discovered this object practically and changes from two states. So it disappeared as millisecond pulsar 4 years ago, and accretion disk emerged again. This was followed with the high increase in the gamma ray emission. And appearance of the disk with double lines, emission lines, typical for disk emission. Start to show sporadic X-ray lines. And showed optical flux increase by 2 magnitude. Typically, this shows the, of course, as has been demonstrated, the optical flux variation with orbital period and color. And also there are indication on the radio jet due to measurement of the radio emission. Distance to the source is measured with parallax, so then a problem, as Lilian told about distance, a problem for the XSS source here, the distance is very fixed by the radio parallax measurement during millisecond pulsar stage. So now it is a low mass X-ray binary state, and here is example of X-ray light cover from Archibald et al. I took it. It is characterized by high and low stages, sharply changed from one to another, and third stage is a flare stages. They are practically stochastic behavior. No. Very important thing it is that spin down rate has been measured during the low mass X-ray binary stage, current stage, and it was only 20% faster than in rotation millisecond pulsar state. And this means that the pulsar wind continues to operate. Even if we do not see the pulsar in the radio, but it works as a rotation pulsar. Previous optical observations in the rotation after the changing to the long mass X-ray binary showed sharp flickering in the optical, the upper. This is obtained from the Earth with the ultracam high time resolution photometer. They seen that some flickering. This was obtained with the XMM Newton optical monitor. The orbital phase variations are clearly seen. This is another example for the light cause variations with integration stamp for 10-20 seconds obtained by Shahbaz. The scene that also, as in X-rays, there are some sharps, dips, and flares. When the sharp dips, flares. And this is a color. It is seen that the object become bluer at low states in during dips and red at flats stage. So I don't know. No, it is interesting that multi-wavelength spectrum during millisecond stage was such that there's a star. Then we have binary shock, interbinary shock, and this is a emission from the gamma ray emission from the probably polar caps of the pulsar and maybe interbinary shock. But when after year, after the summer of 2013, the spectrum changed. So we see the star and disk, and then interbinary shock in X-rays, and huge increase in gamma rays. So this is what about our observations? There is some instrument on BTR produced by BTR group. It was installed at beginning this year. It's a 6-meter telescope, and it allows measure simultaneously light covers in 4 filters, broadband filters, and Stokes parameters with high resolution up to 100 nanoseconds. The construction of or details about this this instrument can be found on the BTR site. And BTR people, they ask it what to observe instead, aside escape escape of Kravnov pulsars, what to observe. And yes, I suggested to observe this source because it is interesting when it will come back to the millisecond pulsar stage. And 6-meter telescope can monitor this and participate in this business. The magnitude of the this system about what is bright enough for this instrument that is very sensitive. But I would like to mention that that is not very quickly absorbed source. EBV is only such a small. And here is an image from the instrument. This is a pulsar or a binary system. This is a comparison star, just taken for to control the operation of instrument. There are some windows by 15 by 13 arc seconds to measure angular arc seconds, to measure the Stokes parameters, intensity, U, and so on. And this is it contains, this instrument contains the position sensitive detector. And this is the image at this detector. This is pulsar. This is background star. And that's what the results of first observation. This is a pulsar. This is a comparison star. Counts time in seconds. And this is a ratio of the pulsar and the comparison star. And it seems that the ratio, there is a gap in observation because poor water, weather, simply. It is seen that the ratio is almost constant. This means, but flux from the star is very stable. So these fluctuations or flyers seen here are real. This is U and B band light cars. They are binned to intervals on 1 second and 1.2 seconds, but the real setup was 0.12 second resolution. It is observations. And it is seen that in U band there is a noise, but in the B band we see sharp light curves, very similar as in X-rays. But if you will average or make a ruder time resolution in U-band, you will see that these flares or dips are reproduced in U-band. Also. So the U-band sensitivity is weaker. Also, yeah, I just demonstrate the capacity of the instrument. We see that sometimes there are spikes, they are real, unresolved. The resolution is such, it's temporal resolution. There are very sharp things. This is a polarimetry, also in B band. This is light cover intensity, and this is a polarization degree. This is a stock is Q, EU, and U parameter. It is seen that polarization is almost only upper limit if such time resolution can be obtained. It's not so, so conservative, but if you average the data with such time, by such time interval, we obtained 3 sigma polarimetry, polarization degree. That sometimes varies flickering. This is during some interval of the observation, about 1,000 arc seconds. We can say that it is upper limit. Upper limit. No, it is not a noise. What is the degree polarization? It is not zero. Zero here. So that is something, some indication that polarization present. So interesting is there are sharp flares. Just an example. The green is a native time resolution, and 0.4 seconds is the resolution of previous observation of Ireland group with ultracam. So it seems that real spikes or flickering is much narrow. Just demonstrate examples at different phases of observations. And yes, sometimes we see periodicities at some intervals. And searching for periodicity shows that possibly there is a quasi-periodical oscillation with such a period. And the summary that the many results are consistent with those obtained with ultracam in 10-10-20, so the pulsar is still in low mass X-ray banners just in February. There is stochastic variability time scales of 0.5 several minutes with amplitudes of 1.2, 1.5, and a typical rising time or full with half maximum width of 0.2 seconds. Such it was not previously resolved with ultracam, so that the instrument is quite competitive. There are some unresolved spikes with low time scale. There is possible linear polarization. And correlation between U and B bands and flux increase reddening during variations, reddening during the flares, quasi-periodic oscillation possible, and the nature is unclear, but source is expected to be in unstable propeller regime. So sometimes it's seen pulses, coherent pulses in X-rays, but sometimes not. So it's an annulling pulsar, radio pulsar, working now. So needs deeper study and modeling. We plan to continue. The instrument shows that it is working, can be used, and we will continue this work.
Okay, thank you. Any quick question? Yeah, go ahead.
Can you show a slide with a spectra of lines?
The spectral?
Spectral.
Oh. This one. This?
Not this, at the beginning.
At the beginning?
Yeah.
Ah, it's here. This one?
This one.
Yes.
Didn't you smooth or bend the spectrum before line identification?
No, this is just, I took this picture from Halpern et al, who found that disk emerged up again after the millisecond pulsar stage, rotation power pulsar stage. But the lines are double. This is typical for disk.
Right, we're running late. We started the session late, so this is a good time to stop. Let's thank all the speakers for the session. And before we depart for lunch, I think there is an announcement by the organizer.
Okay. Not okay? Okay. So I have two announcements. So the one is about conference dinner. I remind that it will be today at 7:30 p.m. And the place is marked by the red spot on this map. The address is Nevsky 86. It's nearby this metro station. And there will be bus transfer starting from here at 8:30 p.m. And also there will be transfer back. Okay. And this, with this map is put there. And also, I announce a conference photo, which will be at the end of the today's sessions, at the main entrance. I think outside, we'll make it outside. The weather is good today, so this time we will make a photo and then transfer to dinner. A question, please. No, from the restaurant. But if you want to depart earlier, you can use a metro or taxi. If you want to depart after, you can use the same alternatives.